builder design pattern. In case of builder design pattern, we shall create one complex object from simple objects in a step-by-step fashion. And this builder design pattern is falling under the creational design pattern category. So builder design pattern builds a complex object using simple objects and using a step-by-step approach. This type of design pattern comes under the creational pattern, as this pattern provides one of the best ways to create an object. A builder class builds the final object step by step. This builder is independent of other objects. To have a better idea on this builder design pattern, let us show you one sample Java application with the respective class diagrams for more detailing. So here is the demonstration for you. Now here we are going to implement builder design pattern. And we have considered one business case of fast food restaurant where a typical meal could be a burger and a cold drink. A burger can be of two types, that is the veg burger and chicken burger, and which will be packed by a wrapper. And cold drink could be either say Coke or Pepsi and will be packed in a bottle. So here we are having two items in our meal. One is the burger, another one is the cold drink. Burger can be of two types, veg burger and chicken burger, which will be packed in a wrapper. And cold drink can be of two types, one is the Coke, another one is the Pepsi, and will be packed in a bottle. So we are going to create an item interface representing food items such as the burgers and the cold drinks, and concrete classes implementing the item interface, and a packing interface representing packing of food items, and concrete classes implementing the packing interface, as burger would be packed in a wrapper, and as I told you earlier, the cold drink would be packed as in a bottle. So we will be having one class, that is a meal class, which will be having the array list of items and menu and the meal builder to build different types of meal objects by combining items, and builder pattern demo, which will be our demo class, and which will use the meal builder to build a meal. So that is the total concept here. We shall be going for the implementation step by step. So step one is that we should be creating an interface item and representing the food items and the packing, that is the item.java and packing.java. So let us go for the item at first. So this is our item, you can find that. So public interface item. So item is nothing but one interface having got this public string name. So name is one method, returns a string. Packing is another method which returns a packing. And here we are having the price is another method which returns applied price in the terms of or of the type of float here. So here we are having one interface known as the item, which is having three methods are there: name, which returns a string, packing, which returns a packing class object, and we will be having the price, which will be returning a float data. So here you see we are having this packing as one interface here. So this is item is actually returning this packing. There is a this particular interface object rather, and this method is packing, and this interface has been defined here. So this particular interface packing is having one method, that is a pack, which returns a string here. So that is we are having this wrapper. This wrapper is implementing this packing. So packing is one interface which is having only one method defined, that is our pack. So wrapper is going to write the body for this method, that is a return wrapper. So this is a wrapper which is implementing this packing interface. Bottle is another class which will be implementing this packing interface, and here the respective pack method is returning the string, that is the bottle. So this is our item interface, we have discussed that one. This is our packing interface, we have discussed that one. And this is a wrapper class implementing packing interface. Bottle class which is implementing the packing interface. Okay, now create concrete classes implementing the packing interface, that is a wrapper.java and bottle.java. So this up to this part we have done. So create abstract classes implementing the item interface providing default functionalities, that is a burger.java and colddrink.java. So item can be of two types, that is a burger.java and colddrink.java. And we know that this particular create concrete classes extending burger and the cold drink classes,
And we know that burger will be of two types, that is a veg burger.java and chicken burger.java, representing veg burger and chicken burger here. And cold drink, this particular is having two types, one is the Coke and the Pepsi. So respective classes will be Coke.java and Pepsi.java. So let us go for that. So here we are having this burger. So which is implementing this item. This burger is implementing this item. We know that in case of item, we are having this name method, we are having this packing method, we are having this price method. So in case of burger, we are just writing this packing here. So this is the abstract class burger implements item. So as it is the abstract class, so here we are overwriting the method, there is a packing, returns new wrapper, and we are having this public abstract float price here. So this item, we are having this price, we are having this float, we are having this packing, we are having this name, and here we are having this burger here, we have defined that one accordingly. Which is, so burger is nothing but one abstract class which is implementing item. Next, we are going for this cold drink. So cold drinks is also another abstract class which is implementing the interface item. And here, this particular method packing, we have written the body for that, return new bottle. So in case of burger, returns new wrapper. In case of cold drink, it returns new bottle. So now we will be going for this Pepsi. So this is a Pepsi here, so which extends the cold drink. So this is a cold drink.java. We know that this is the abstract class. So this is a Pepsi which is extending this cold drink. Here this price, we are overriding this price method. The return value is 35.0 in the data type of float, in the type of float. And there is a name method is also getting overwritten, so it returns a Pepsi. So in case of Pepsi, we are having this. So now let us go for our Coke here. So we are writing this Coke, mentioning the price and the Coke returned as a string here. Now we shall go for this veg burger. We can go for this veg burger, which extends burger. So we know that burger is nothing but one abstract class here. So that is an abstract class burger implements item. So we are going for this veg burger. And here we are just defining this method, the price which returns this value and name as the veg burger. So now let us go for the chicken burger here. So this is the chicken burger which extends the burger, mentioning the price and the respective name, which will be returned in the as a type of string from this method name here. So now up to this part we have done. So now we create a meal class having item objects defined above, that is a meal.java. And then we'll be going to define one meal builder. So this particular meal builder class, that is the actual builder class responsible to create the meal objects. And we'll be having the last class, that is a builder pattern demo, which uses the meal builder to demonstrate the builder pattern here. So now we'll be going for the meal. This is our meal.java. So here we have used one array list of items. There is a new array list item. It will be holding the item objects in this array list. And we are having this add item, which will add items to this array list items. We are having this get cost. So initially, I'm just initializing cost with the value of zero float. And then for each and every item, whatever we'll be having in this array list, the respective prices are going to be added and the final cost will be returned of the type float. We're having this show items. So using this for each, so item, object, item, which will be found in this items array list, the respective name, the packing.pack, and then we are having this price. So item.packing method.pack method, and this item.price method, which will print the respective price, packing, and the item here. Okay, now we'll be going for the next one. That is the menu builder.java. This is our menu builder. It is having two methods. One is the prepare veg meal and prepare non-veg meal. So meal, so there is a meal we are having. So its object has been defined here. Meal is equal to new meal. So meal.add item new veg burger and meal.add item new Coke. So respective objects will be added with this meal. So you know that this meal is having actually one array list, that is the items. So there these objects are actually going to get added, because you know that in case of add item, this items.add item we have written. So whatever the parameter we are passing here, objects we are passing here, they are going to get added into that array list defined under this meal class. So return meal, in case of prepared non-veg meal, we'll be taking this chicken burger here, and we are going to add this Pepsi object there. So the last one, that is our demo, builder pattern demo. So which is defining one menu builder is equal to new menu builder. So we are defining one menu builder class object here, and then we are going for the prepared veg meal. So system.out.println veg meal, and then veg meal.show items. It will print all the respective items which will be included in the veg meal, and then for the non-veg meal, the items are to be printed, and the respective costs will be also getting printed here. So now let me execute my code. So in case of veg meal, item is veg burger, packing is equal to wrapper, price is equal to this, item is equal to Coke, packing is bottle, and the price will be this, and total will be 25 plus 30, that is a 55 here. And for the non-veg meal also, we're having the chicken burger, packing wrapper, price is equal to, we can also get the price. The price is 50.5, and item is Pepsi, packing bottle, and price is 35.0. So if you go on adding, it is 85.5 here. So in this way, in this particular demonstration, we are just showing that how to define different classes for the implementation of this builder design pattern. So now let us go for, this is a class diagram we are getting here. This is a class diagram. So this is the meal builder you are getting here. There is a Java class. Builder pattern demo. This is the constructor we are having. This is the main function under the public scope of type static. This is our meal. You can find that this is a meal add item. This is a get cost and show items we are having. This is a cold drink. This cold drink is nothing but one Java class here. And we are having this Pepsi and the Coke. You can easily find that this cold drink, you can just let me go for that. There's a cold drink is there. So cold drink is of the type abstract class. So that's why it is having two implementers. So one is the Pepsi, another one is the Coke. And this meal is having multiple items there in the array list. The name of the array list is items. And this is about packing. So packing is the one Java interface, and its implemented classes are bottle and wrapper. We're having this burger here. So this burger is the chicken burger and the veg burger. So now let me go for the burger here. So this is a burger. So it is abstract class. So this is the veg burger is actually extending this burger and also the chicken burger. So accordingly, we are getting this class diagram here. So there is a chicken burger which is extending this burger abstract class, and this is a veg burger also extending this abstract class burger here. So this is the respective class diagram. You can easily find that how this class diagram has been drawn, and this is the implementation of builder design pattern. Thanks for watching this video.